Methadrine was first distilled by a Japanese scientist before World War II. Handed to the Japanese, they knew a good thing when they saw it. This guy's so tweaked, he probably thinks he can survive this without a scratch. Maybe not. By some estimates, 2% of the Japanese population had a meth problem after the war. Factory workers, soldiers, pilots. Maybe that's why it took 2 bombs to get him to surrender. A nuclear blast is just a minor nuisance to a determined tweaker. In the 50s, the housewives got a hold of it. Dexedrine, benzedrine, methadrine. Now that's a classic speed freak for you. Skinny and cleaning house. I bet her poor husband never knew what hit him in the sack either. There were even rumors that one of our presidents dabbled with mysterious energy shots. Imagine that, a slammer in the White House. If it's true, I bet old Khrushchev never got a word in edgewise. By the late 60s, the government finally cracked down and sent the whole thing underground. Bikers control the market for a while. But now, anyone with a basic chemistry kit and the right ingredients can cook it up at home. Ever see a long-haired tattooed freak buying up all the cold medicine he can lay his hands on at 3 in the morning? Take it from me, he doesn't have a cold. He's a cook. Look in his kitchen and you'll find a whole grocery list of unsavory ingredients. Drain cleaner, hydrochloric acid, match heads for red phosphorus, ether, and of course, the cold medicine. That's for the ephedrine, soon to become methadrine. This guy's a regular Julia child. Problem is, I'll bet even Julia screws up the bouillabaisse from time to time. Uh-oh.